top of the morning, guys. How's everyone doing? Hope everyone's having a blessed day. Happy Friday, TGI Friday. So today, like I said, continuing off last video, we got the Mustang picked up. They actually tore apart the engine. Haven't told me exactly what's wrong with it just quite yet. I texted them this morning and they said they finally got it on an engine hoist. They had already unplugged everything out of the engine bay and everything. Let's go ahead and hop in here. We're gonna get a cold start because we're gonna be visiting them today. I'll be in the area that they live, so. I'm gonna go get a haircut here this morning because my hair is looking nappy. It's real bad. I'm way overdue for a haircut. I've been kind of holding it off because I have a wedding to go to next Friday. So we're gonna go check up on the car. We're gonna see all the progress that they've made. Hopefully we're gonna get a complete diagnosis of what exactly is wrong with the engine. Because like I said, as long as I've had this car, I do not know exactly what is wrong with the engine, aside from the fact that it's super locked up, which they told me yesterday. Hey, like, it's like, as you said, the motor is super locked up. And I was like, yeah, I know. I've took it to like multiple shops and they've all said the same thing. I even tried to crank the car myself, not budging at all. So hopefully today we'll finally get a full rundown what exactly is wrong with it. Like I said, hopefully it's nothing major. Hopefully it's just like one or two parts. We can throw the thing back together, put it in the engine. It'll be good to go.
All right, guys. We are arriving. He said to park in the front. They got the car in the back. I guess. Oh, see, they got another Mustang up here too. That one's lowered. Damn. Thing's looking clean. Look at that. Hella static. I like those rims too. Sheesh.
But before we go in, what do y'all think is actually wrong with the engine, aside from the fact that it's locked up? I'm really hoping it's nothing like super, super major, so it's not gonna cost me an arm and a leg, but I don't know. I don't know what to expect. Because he said the car, they have the engine torn apart, but they have not texted me because I've been busy all day. So I guess they knew I told them I was coming. So I don't even know what to expect. I'm hoping, honestly, it's just like a bent rod. It was a bent rod or something. Something easy that's going to be easy to replace and fix. I'm really hoping that nothing got damaged with the block. I don't really know what to expect, guys. But before we go check out my car, let's check out this other 5.0 that they got out here. Because that joint's looking clean. Needs a wash. Oh, if I got that, it'd be carbon fiber. These wheels though, what is he running back here? It's 275s, that's 270, damn. I'm gonna be running 305, so mine's gonna be really, really fat. That's crazy. Let's see, what does he got right up here? 275s all around. Huh. It's not bad,
right? There's no scratches on your walls whatsoever. See a little bit burner thing. I think they burned this car with 85 just because the way they smell and the way it's burning.
Oh, so it was on the 85?
Yeah, it was on the 85. Like you see, that's the 85 seal and stuff right there.
Okay.
Spin it on this one. But then again, I don't see no scarring, you know, on the piston, on the cylinders themselves. So the cylinders walls look good, and they didn't shoot no piston out.
Okay.
So, you know, most likely your main bearings right there, you know, they all went shit.
So you're saying the pistons are good though, even though they look like that?
No, I mean, well, this is just carbon.
Oh, okay.
And it's just burnt. So if I get a wire brush, you're not gonna make it look brand new.
Oh, okay.
So.
Gotcha. I need to order a new crank.
Well, you know, crank might be good. You know, it might just be the rods, the bearings and things like that. See, after we put them on and everything, we can just do that.
Gotcha.
We'll make it look good again.
Okay. Yeah.
So that ain't the problem. But, you know, now we're going back to what we have first, you know, talk about. Mm-hmm. If you buy a crank, I still got to take it to the machine shop and get it put on. It's not something that I want to put on just because clearance and warranties, right? So if you want to take the Glock and get it done, you know, wherever you want to get it done and bring it to me, that's also, you know, an idea. But what I see, you know, your Glock is good. So you got a bad mains, and that's basically where, you know, where are you wearing? Basically, that's where it's locked up. Because if you even look at the pistons, you know, there's play. So that's a good thing. That means that it's not locked in here. It's locked in here. And we can actually pull them out if you want to take a look at it. I wanted you to get here before you show it.
Okay.
Full of things.
Don't know.
Let's find out.
Get ready.
Look at this.
How long did it take you guys to pull everything out?
Started yesterday. Joey mostly did everything, so it took too long.
Yeah.
Done this thing once or twice.
Yeah. Is that your 5-0 out there?
Yeah.
What do you have done to it?
Everything.
Everything?
Everything.
Saw a button in there. You got NOS?
Yes.
Okay. So that means the car already had a tune on it, I guess, then, too. If it was on E85.
Yeah, that got the smell.
I already planned on putting it on E85, so. Of course, the last one. I was like,
yeah.
Oh, what the?
Yeah, that completely just broke.
Yeah, it was spun all the way.
We can do this.
See if we can spin it backwards a little bit.
Okay.
Ouch!
Gotcha.
Yep.
Ten big burgers?
You got it. Well, I wanna see if you can.
Oh, the other one?
I'll put it back on top, bro. Your finger like that.
It'll catch you.
That's what the problem is. Right there.
Right
there. All right. Don't slide your finger like that. Like a little piece of metal or something. Uh-oh. You can catch him.
Get over here.
Well, this is it's on the outside, but this is where the current got caught. Let's take off the pistons, you notice?
Yeah,
we're already here. So
this is all for me right here.
These old ass cats. I'm not gonna be using. To get a short block basically done.
So I'll need to get the short block and the crank done.
Well, the short block is actually what it's called. This is a short block, right?
Uh-huh.
So what it's called a short block is, you know, they do everything, put the pistons, everything, right?
Gotcha.
So they put the pistons, make sure all the caps, you know, new bearings everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to put the same bearing, even though they look good, we don't want to put them back in because they already had a starvation.
Right.
So, you know, the smallest minimals, you know, wear and tear there is gonna be bad at a long term. If you're already here, might as well spend a couple of $100
right
to get new bearings all the way.
Right, yes, right.
And, you know, this one right here is basically seized up in here.
Where?
You know, these are here?
They're right there?
Yeah, you see where we're able to put the other one, all right?
Mm-hmm.
This one right here, I can't get it out. That's how.
Oh, really?
That's how.
Oh, wow.
It's fucking melted to that shit.
Yeah, it's.
So what, all like overheated?
Well, since he had no oil lead.
Mm-hmm.
It don't want to come out. But basically, you know, that's true. That's what we're looking at.
Okay. Yeah, damn.
You ate that one up.
Yep.
And this is
nice out. I'm getting a little concerned because I started taking out bearings. Not good, and I'm like,
what's the problem?
You
want to
hold
the gym?
Oh, I'm about to get it.
Okay.
And you kept saying good, good, and I was like, well, shit.
I was like, good, good, good.
Like,
yes. Good. I'm like. If you're lucky enough, and like I want to tell you, it looks okay, but I wouldn't be able to confirm it. Mm-hmm. This belly looks good, right? Mm-hmm. So this is your bearings. This one looks good. You see how it has a coating? That's for warranty purposes, right? So that's why you got the coating everything right here, right? The other one is worn out. That's why that's how Ford can see, you know, a bad bearing or something like that. Yeah. So this one here, it seems like it's only just a bad bearing here. Best case scenario, they put your new bearings all the way around. Mm-hmm. You know, fix your crank, put it together, good to go.
Okay.
You know, I don't think you need to buy a short block. I think professional, but what I know, I feel like this block looks good.
Okay.
I don't see no scar on the cylinders.
Okay.
I don't see no scar in here. Even that this is where the bearing was bad.
Right.
It looks clean. It doesn't look tear or nothing.
Right.
They might tell you otherwise, so but what I know, it looks clean. These ones look clean, like nothing happened to these ones right here, which is that one right there that went bad. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess this is the one that took all the damage. So like I said, I mean, they might just put you a new one here. Well, of course, they're going to change all of them. I don't think they just changed that one.
Right.
And they'll fix your crank right here. So you see where it's scarring at? They can leave it like this because it's just gonna, it will just scar basically the new bearing. Yeah, so what they do is they polish it, they make it basically flat all over again, and then put it together, right? With new bearings on the pistons and everything.
Okay. Right.
So that's why I'd rather put it on, you know, basically on the customer. Like, you know, wherever you want to get it done, get the short block, you know, built, basically.
Yeah.
So I can just put the heads, put everything back together, and we just put it back in your car.
Okay.
I called the guy a little bit before you did here.
Mm-hmm.
You got here. He gave me a quote, $2,300. That was saying that all the caps were bad, and the caps are the big old things that we pulled out of here.
Mm-hmm.
That quote was given to me, given that all the caps were bad, and that the crank wasn't rebuilt. Right. Mm-hmm. That was worst case scenario for a short block.
Okay.
Now I have to take it to him, and basically they're gonna see, and then they're gonna call me with a more accurate estimate.
Okay.
Like I said, that was my, you know, before you got here, like I said, before I even disassembled it, because I wasn't sure if you were going to, you know, had a whole block already rebuilt, you know, how block just for a swap, but that's why I didn't take it apart.
Mm-hmm.
So I wasn't sure if, you know, if to take it apart or not. So, you know, whenever they gave me the quote, it was just saying that all of these were going to be bad, that there was going to be some scarring on the main caps, right? Mm-hmm. And they were going to have to maybe put a new cap, maybe put a new crank. You know, that's the quote that they gave me, $2,300.
Okay.
By what I see, I mean, I don't think none of the caps are bad. I just think you basically was just right here.
Mm-hmm.
It might be less. Well, I know it's gonna be less than that. After that, gaskets, right?
Gaskets, yeah.
Like full gasket set for, you know, open, head gaskets, you know, basically front cover. You know, just get a full gasket set.
Can I get that from Summit?
Anywhere, you know, as long as it's a full, wherever you, you know, choice
full
one.
Third gen Coyote 5.0.
Yeah, wherever gaskets. You want. You know, just a full, you know, full gasket kit. You know, for valve covers and everything. Head bolts. You know, if you want to go with ARP.
ARP, yeah.
That'll be my best recommendation. If you want to go OEM, same thing. You know, I torque them to spec, whichever ones you want to do. So, you know, but I guess I can tell Joey just to send you a full list and you can just go.
Yeah, if you
can
do that, yeah.
You can just go revise that. Yeah.
outside. I mean,
and I told Joey that that ain't shit on winter time.
Yeah, when it be hitting that 15 to.
He sounds like a piston is just gonna come out. I mean, just
grah. Yeah.
You know, it gets quiet. Give my rabbit a little rabbit joint. Let me hear what it sounds like. You're rabbit a little bit. Don't sound. It's louder, but it's a nice loud when you're rabbit. It's not whenever you're.
You hook with 275?
Yeah. That's what Joey said. Are you hooked?
Yeah. I mean, in the summer it hooks.
So,
jeez.
That's basically that. It's just a little bit of everything and dust that shit. And Joey's like, "Gus, you never clean your car?" And I'm like, "No." Got Xerox screws going around it, you know?
Did you paint it black?
The block.
Oh, the block, okay.
Yeah. No. The rest of it is just original. Yeah.
You put the headers on yourself and everything?
Yeah, everything done myself, so. See, Joey?
Yeah, it's the same fucking thing.
I told you. Joey's like, "Cuz, I can't get this head out this side."
Yeah, I couldn't. I was able to. I done did all the bolts on this side. And
he was like, "Gus,
I was like, it's not gonna fucking come out.
It's impossible." And I'm like, "Joey, I done it."
He went, "Push that motherfucker out."
I was like, "Joey, I done it." He go like, "No, Gus, it's not gonna work." And I'm like, "Dude, you trust me." And I just got out there and just did it. And
it came off.
Came off, yeah.
All right, guys, so basically, that's the whole rundown of what's wrong with the engine. So basically, he said the crank hub has a little scratch on one end of it. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take it to the machine shop. They're gonna fix that, patch that up, make it like it was brand new. They're gonna replace the hubs. We're gonna get new pistons and whatever else I'm gonna need. We're gonna upgrade APR studs. He was talking about, since everything is basically out of the car, anything that I wanna go ahead and upgrade to, I might as well. I'm gonna have to think about if I wanna upgrade the clutch or not. I'm not entirely sure because I'm still not the best manual driver. This is definitely gonna be a learning curve. I'm definitely gonna learn once I have this car in my possession. It'll definitely be, you know, something to think about moving forward. And I'll be honest with you guys, it's not costing me a whole lot, because originally I was gonna take my car to a performance shop. They were gonna charge me at least 10K. They said 8 to 10K, but let's be honest, it's probably gonna be more so 10K. With me going through my friend here, I'm gonna be spending at most $2,000. I'm gonna go ahead and order the short throw shifter as well as the oil pump gears and the crank sprocket. There's a few more things I'll have to order, like all the gaskets. I would expect to have the engine back by next week. Then once I get that back, I probably still won't have the car for a little while, especially if I do decide to upgrade some parts here and there. So the car is still, like I said, it's gonna be down for the next few weeks, but no more than a month. And then we just gotta get the body work completed and then the car will be good to go. I'll try and keep you guys in on the process. Probably give you an update by next week. As soon as I know something from them, it probably might be a short little video. If you guys enjoyed the video, please like, share, subscribe. Like I said, we got big things coming from the channel. So aside from that, guys, always remember to keep shifting forward.
Yeah, feel me. I might sip out this bottle until it get hollow. Shit, I might sip out this bottle, just drowning my sorrows. Drowning my sorrows, be better tomorrow. Cause these broken dreams is as hard as it gets. My nigga died at only 25, I'm thanking God for letting me see in 26, shit.